Hello and welcome. I am Charlie Anarkan, Global Lead for the Manufacturing and Resources Industry at Microsoft. Today, we're talking about one of the most important advances in manufacturing and resources, artificial intelligence. AI is everywhere, in our networks, in our data centers, in our devices, in every application, enabling collaboration between people and machines. At Microsoft, we have an approach that is both ambitious and broad, an approach that seeks to democratize AI, making it accessible for all. In this special two-part series, we will delve deeper into what our AI-enabled future looks like. We will approach it from both sides. In this first episode, we will explore the powerful new opportunities AI opens up in terms of technology innovation. In part two of the series, we will look at the important questions around ethics and trust when it comes to ensuring that AI is designed, used, and governed responsibly. Welcome to Digital Empowerment. With me here today is Indranil Sirkar, our CTO of Manufacturing and Resources, who will share exciting examples of AI innovation. Later, during our discussion, we will hear from Ted Wei, Senior Program Manager for Azure Machine Learning. Ted will give us an inside look at Microsoft AI advancements, including a demo of Project Brainwave. Indranil, let us start with you. Thank you very much for being here today.
I'm very happy to be here, Charyan.
Indranil, of all the technologies reshaping our industry, I would say that AI has one of the biggest roles here in terms of the disruption and resulting opportunity for our businesses, our industries, for everyone, our world at large.
Yes, absolutely.
So can you tell us more about Microsoft's vision for empowering transformation through AI?
Yeah, every company is unique, and there is no single path to driving AI transformation. Our approach to Microsoft AI is to meet you wherever you are in your transformation journey. Now, it could be by infusing AI into your existing environment or using an AI-powered business application. A major differentiator is that Microsoft AI and data platform enables you to reason over data no matter where it resides. Whether data is on-premise, in the cloud, or in the edge, you don't need to move your data to reason over it. Recently, we announced Azure enhancements with new capabilities to run containerized applications on the edge, industrial IoT workloads, and training machine learning models. Azure is engineered for future with capabilities like enterprise-grade service level agreements, scale, built-in privacy, compliance, and security that the manufacturer needs to make AI real for every application, every business process, and every employee.
Indranil, across all industries, AI offers us new ways to boost employee productivity and creativity, increase business agility, improve customer engagement, and jumpstart new product innovation. And that is just the beginning of what's possible. Now, tell us more, if you will, about how AI is empowering the digital leadership agenda across the industry.
Yes, I mean, we view this from three different perspectives. Specifically from an industrial IoT perspective, manufacturers are using AI to optimize processes such as predictive maintenance, quality, smart systems, and so on. As we start to discuss more about intelligent manufacturing or factory of the future, we are seeing AI-enabled processes like CNC machine calibration to automate tuning to significantly accelerate manual processes with operator-level precision, or collaborative robots, and also within health and safety scenarios, among others. Second, we continue to see AI driving significant workforce transformation, starting with accelerating the need for skills enhancement. One of the examples would be using mixed reality by augmenting employee skills, redefining training and skills transfer, while increasing the efficiencies on the shop floor. The third area would be sustainability. This is critical to our industry as we consume natural resources, including energy and water. We also need to think about waste management. Many manufacturers today are already utilizing green energy and initiatives like circular economy to drive sustainable approach to manufacturing. AI is also transforming energy subvertical. For example, AI is enabling autonomous inspection of grid assets in power and utilities, and digital asset management product quality and performance in oil and gas.
And now we know that AI is very, very critical to sustainability. Microsoft has invested big in programs like AI for Earth and AI for Good. These extend the power of AI towards solving some of the world's biggest challenges to create a more sustainable and accessible world.
Yes, exactly. I mean, the potential here cannot be understated. I mean, AI can play an important role in monitoring the health of our planet. It can help us unlock insights that will help us reduce climate change, conserve energy, and preserve natural resources like water through sustainable manufacturing practices. AI is also what will help us feed our growing population. When it comes to precision agriculture, AI is enabling capabilities like precision farm input, land cover mapping and assessment, and so much more. Like through sensors, drones, connectivity, data analytics and AI, Microsoft is enabling precision agriculture through programs like FarmBeats to improve yield while reducing resource consumption. And Microsoft AI for Good program basically uses AI to help save lives through things like disaster recovery, addressing the needs of children, protecting displaced people, and promote human rights.
Indrano, this is simply mind-blowing. It's just an amazing time. The true impact of AI will be the greatest when we all work together to really transform our world. That is what we're talking about here, aren't we? Our focus is to help manufacturers achieve strategies that incorporate sustainability and create value for their businesses, their customers, their communities. Let's make it real. Can you give us a few examples of what manufacturers are doing today in some of these important areas?
Of course. When it comes to sustainability, we are working with companies like Ecolab to provide and protect clean water, safe food, and abundant energy. One example of our work together is the Water Risk Monetizer. Based on Azure, this tool helps companies understand and reduce their water usage. On the factory side of it, BAE Systems, along with our partner PTC, is using HoloLens and mixed reality to help first-line workers assemble battery cells in less time and train new people 30 or 40% more efficiently. Another example would be the use of AI in manufacturing quality. And, you know, Jabil has been using machine learning and cognitive AI in their manufacturing line to improve quality and reduce waste. Let me turn to Ted, as he has been closely associated with this project from engineering.
Thanks, Indranil. Hey, Shalyan.
Hello, Ted.
Jabil is one of the most advanced manufacturers in the world. What they're doing with circuit boards that they manufacture is that they're analyzing the circuit boards and using AI to predict whether there are manufacturing defects. So the circuit board is coming down the assembly line. And today, they're taking pictures of it, and a human has to look at those pictures. And they only have a few seconds to make a decision as to whether there's a manufacturing defect or not. So this is something that's really ripe for AI. We worked with Jabil to build AI models that would analyze the pictures and predict whether there's a manufacturing defect or not. And the great thing about this is this really speaks to Microsoft's vision of using AI to amplify human ingenuity. Because now the people can then take the insights from the data and then be able to look at whether there's a root cause for causing this manufacturing defect. They can spend time on doing that higher value work rather than just looking at these pictures, because the AI model can look at these pictures. Now, these AI models are also very big and complex. ResNet 50 is one of the models, and it has 8 billion calculations. On a typical CPU, if you want to just process a few images, that's no problem at all. But when you have an entire factory, multiple assembly lines, multiple assembly line steps, you're talking about a ton of data. So it really needs some form of acceleration of that AI. And that's the work that we're doing with Project Brainwave. By infusing Microsoft Research Project Brainwave into Azure Machine Learning, we're able to help Jabil's data scientists accelerate that AI. What you're seeing here is what the data scientists will use. This is a Jupyter notebook. They're writing code in Python. They're using TensorFlow. These are all familiar tools that data scientists use today. They don't have to learn anything new to be able to take advantage of hardware acceleration of AI models on FPGAs. So as you can see here, the steps are fairly simple to be able to train and deploy that model. Here's an example of a picture that's coming off the AOI machine. So I'm going to send this picture to my model, and then I'm going to predict whether there's a manufacturing defect or not. And you can see here that the score says there's no defect, and the result comes back in 11 milliseconds. This means that the time that it takes the picture to leave this machine, go to the API, run on the FPGA, and come back is 11 milliseconds. ResNet 50, with its 8 billion calculations, only takes 1.8 milliseconds of that time. So let me jump over now to an app that we built to showcase how fast this is running on the FPGAs. You can see that I'm sending images to the model to the API on the FPGA. Median latency is only 6 milliseconds, again, for that AI model. And let me kick up the number of threads because we're not sending images fast enough. And you can see that we're saturating that FPGA. We're getting close to 500 images per second in this case to be able to analyze the images and determine whether there are manufacturing defects or not. With these preliminary results, we've seen that this model eliminates about 75% of past components, and it's correctly predicting 92% of the defects. We're super excited about relationships like this, where we can bring in AI and to help them amplify their human ingenuity.
Ted, this is tremendous. How can we take the learnings from Jabil's work and apply it to other manufacturers?
The great thing about the learnings is that this pattern is repeatable anytime you have images. So if you have images of auto components, if you have images of plastic molding, any types of products, we're able to retrain a model to be able to identify those defects on those products. And not only are we able to do that with pictures coming from existing cameras, we're also partnering with other hardware partners. So for example, we have a partnership with Qualcomm in which we're building this vision AI development kit. Qualcomm has built some chips that are able to accelerate AI models, just like we're doing with Project Brainwave and FPGAs. So now this camera can then take in pictures of scenes for workplace safety. It's able to identify whether there are things that are not supposed to be in a certain area. And we're doing a pilot with Shell in their gas stations. One of the most dangerous things in a gas station are fires. And so one of the risky behaviors that lead to fires are people smoking. And so we built an AI model with Shell that would take in images, identify whether there's someone smoking in a gas station, and then be able to send an alert. So now you think about these cameras that are able to identify risky behavior, take in those images, process it directly on the camera, and then save the bandwidth by not having to send this to the internet. All this camera is doing now is sending an alert, and the gas station attendant can identify whether there are risky behaviors happening in that gas station. So again, whether it's workplace safety, whether it's going to be products on the assembly line, a lot of the things that are occurring in manufacturing, we're able to use AI to help them out.
Ted, I'm blown away by how our customers are using AI to innovate like never before. Thank you so much. And thank you so much in general. It'll be exciting to see, even 1 year from now, how far AI will take us in terms of breaking new ground in the industry. Thank you all for joining us here today, and stay tuned for part 2 in our AI series.